Денеска имаме чест да го угостиме на некој начин Джордж Патапатију, кој што е професор и представник на Интернационалната академија за хомеопатија од Грција, еден од најпознатите светски институти за хомеопатија. Како што знаете, хомеопатијата е една алтернативна гранка во медицината, за која што се уште постојат многу неусогласености со класичната медицина. Она што денеска ќе го видиме е представување на некои од основните принципи на хомеопатијата, меѓутоа исто така и на студиските програми за хомеопатија кои што се интернационално признати и кои што господинот Джордж денеска ќе ни ги представи на некој начин да ги запознае нашите вработени, нашите студенти со тоа што е се возможно да се студира, на каков начин да се студира и кои се поволностите од тоа студирање. Хомеопатијата сигурно нема да биде една од гранките што многу брзо ќе биде воведена на секаде и призната на секаде, меѓутоа развојот и ефектите што досега се постигнуваат од ова алтернативна медицина во голем број на делови од медицината се фасцинантни и фасцинирачки, така да можеме слободно да кажеме дека можеби ќе биде една од гранките на медицината на 21-виот век што ќе донесе најголем прогрес во медицината.
I am more than happy to be here and I really thank and appreciate your attention.
There is a lot of criticism about homeopathy that is not evidence-based medicine. Is it evidence-based medicine and what do you think why there is a lot of criticism?
Well, from the World Health Organization. There is a lot of criticism. This is when you speak about, I am basically a medical doctor, a conventional medical doctor. I have studied in a university hospital, in a university like, I have worked in a university hospital, and I had the chance to meet homeopathia. Now, what I can say is that I cannot answer to your question with 2 minutes. I cannot answer this question in 2 minutes. This question is not answered for 100 years. What I will tell you that we cannot ignore 2 facts. One fact is that worldwide there are 600 million patients who choose homeopathy than conventional medicine. We cannot ignore that fact. And the second thing that we cannot ignore the clinical effects which are obvious when you use homeopathy. This is what I'm going to say about this.
World Health Organization is advising for some disease that we shouldn't use homeopathy, and it is advising the local doctors that should not use homeopathy about certain disease.
I cannot comment about this. I will tell you the same. We cannot ignore the fact that 600 million people worldwide, they want to be treated through homeopathy, and they are treated by homeopathy. So we cannot ignore this fact. We are not here to convince somebody sure. about the effectiveness of homeopathy. I'm not here to do that. I'm not here to tell you that use that, don't use the other thing. We are scientists. We are open-minded. I believe everybody is open-minded. We are free people. And I believe that all the students, I was a student at the time, our objective is to help our patients, correct? Sure. So if we can help our patients, sometimes with homeopathy, I think this is an advantage.
Their argument is that there is no evidence.
No, I will tell you. No, this is not the argument.
The argument of the World Health Organization.
Let me tell you what is the argument. I know very well what is the argument. The basic argument is that when a substance is very diluted, there is no molecule in the... There is a big discussion about this, but again, you will permit me not to enter in details about this because we can speak 10 hours about that. Believe me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you use homeopathy in Greece in general hospitals?
No. They don't. Only in private practice.
In the public.
Only private practice. In the public hospital, no. Of course not. Of course. But there are a lot of my colleagues who are working in state hospitals and they are homeopaths at the same time. Or I have had. Many friends who had a work in a state hospital and they decided to quit and to private practice homeopathy.
What about public hospitals in the Western world?
In the Western
world? Do we have that kind of examples?
For example, I will tell you one simple example. In NHS, this is the health system of UK, It is in their healthcare. Homeopathy is in the healthcare, so it is in the public system. Patients who would like to use homeopathy get their money back by the insurance of the state insurance, the public insurance. So it depends on the system, but as far as I know, it's more official in Switzerland, in France, and in England. In Greece, it's not yet. That's a fact. But in Greece, it's the, you know, it's based in Alonissos, the International Academy of Homeopathy, with founded by Mr. Vithulkas, who is assumed to be the guru of homeopathy. He is the only homeopath to ever receive the alternative Nobel, you know, for his efforts in homeopathy. That's a fact. Thank you.